From 1930 to 1945, more than 20,000 women and girls were trafficked or forced into sexual slavery by the Japanese army in occupied territories, including Korea, China, and the Philippines. Referred to as comfort women, these women were held in brothels called comfort stations for the purpose of boosting Japanese soldiers' morale. They lived in harsh conditions where they were subjected to rape from up to 100 soldiers a day. If they resisted, they would be beaten or murdered. Only 25-30% of these women survived the war, and those who did survive forever lived with both physical and mental pain. After noticing that many Westerners didn't know about the tragic history of comfort women, playwright Dimo Kim decided to take a theatrical approach to shed a light on their often untold story. Based on real-life accounts of a few surviving comfort women, he wrote the musical also titled Comfort Women, which follows several Korean women who were tricked into working at comfort stations in Indonesia.
Everyone was like, what's comfort woman? And that was like kind of shock to me, because I know all like Holocaust and everything, but they said, like, comfort women, like, are they women who's comfortable? Like, they never think it's sexual slaves. And I was shocked, and I started writing the some scenes, and everybody was like sobbing because they never heard about the story.
We know that there are so many Chinese women are taken to Japan or somewhere else be a comfort woman, but I really don't know there's also so many people other than Chinese, they're also forced to be a comfort woman at around the world.
Dimo also shared that over the years, while the historical truth about comfort women has been unearthed, the issue has become a political topic. Survivals have sometimes been used to help realize political pursuits of others. What's more important than restoring the historical truth is to simply see these survivors as individuals and to give them love and care.
Still, survivors are there, and none of the government, even Korean government or Japanese government, other government, are not focusing on the survivors. They're focusing on the fact of the comfort women they're using as a political game. And I think it's still relevant because survivors are there, and people need to hear about their story, not about relationship between East Asians.
It's worth noting that in Comfort Women, Dimo recruits an all-Asian cast in an industry where leading opportunities are rare. Having seen Asian talents usually only getting supporting or actor roles in the American entertainment industry, Dimo hopes to solve the problem of Asians being underrepresented from the root. Creating more stories about the Asian community will lead to more opportunities for Asian talents and to attract more investment.
I would say just it feels different being an Asian community because that don't happen very often. But also at the same time, I feel we Asians are super powerful and capable. Because from what I know, a lot of people just think, oh, Asians, they're good at math. They can't express their face, they can't cry, but those are not true. Like, we're just as expressive as all other races.
Right now, all the Asian actors or Asian communities blame white producers that why are not casting Asian actors, or why are changing Asian characters to the colorblind casting. But it's actually the point should be us. It's our fault because we didn't portray the stories. We didn't taking a risk to put the stories up. We always just working with the Broadway theaters or like white powers. And that's the reason why we didn't make any infrastructure before. And I think this is the time all the Asian artists or directors should be work together and generate more Asian roles. That way we have more Asian stars. And that way we have more Asian investors that makes Asian producer and make good circle.
Off-Broadway musical Comfort Women will be at Peter J. Sharp Theater from July 20th to September 2nd. To find out more about SunVision English Channel, please visit our website at en.sunvision.net or follow our Facebook page at SunVision Official.